Why is Coca-Cola getting into the restaurant business? What are you telling investors, and are they still concerned about that?
Yeah, look, what we say is this is a coffee strategy. Clearly, the Costa has stores, and it's been a component of building the brand and building the experience. But as we look globally about what can we do in the coffee category, we see a number of very important opportunities that can allow us to be an even better provider of beverage solutions to lots of customers, whether it's in many of the immediate consumption channels and food service, with beans and machines, or they have a special vending machine, which is a bit like our modern freestyle machine that we have for sparkling beverages. They have a vendor for coffee, which is excellent. So there are a lot of immediate consumption channels. We can work with those customers and those channels. We can go to the at-home occasion with pods and beans and capsules. And of course, we can bring ready-to-drink coffee to many more parts of the world. Curiously, we're leaders in ready-to-drink coffee, but all driven out of our Japanese business, and there's a tremendous opportunity for that to expand around the world. What we needed and what this acquisition provides for us is a brand that has international portability and a supply chain and coffee capability that can allow us to execute at scale.
Not sure if you heard, even Indra Nooyi seemed to take a shot at you. On her final conference call as CEO, James, she was asked about coffee, and she said, the only thing we're not going to do again is get into the restaurant business.
Well, she's entitled to all her own opinions. I mean, what we're clear about is that we've got a coffee strategy, and that we see an opportunity to participate really strongly in a category that's growing around the world, in value, and I think there's a lot that can be done to be a better provider of beverages for every customer, including coffee.
Speaking of growing categories in the beverage space, it sounds like you're playing down the move and the development into cannabis after a report that you guys were looking into a CBD product. Can you just bring us up to speed? Because investors were really excited about that.
Yeah, I mean, look, we've got no plans in the cannabis or marijuana or CBD space at this moment. I don't see that as something that we'll be getting into anytime soon. It's just not something we're interested in.
What about body armor? You really think you can go up against Gatorade? Is that the plan here?
Yeah, body armor is a really exciting investment. We like the brand. We think they're doing very interesting things in the sports and the premium hydration space. And I think this investment provides us an opportunity to both expand the category and gain some share and provide consumers with more access to a great brand and a great product and see where it goes.